Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. There are some songs that are written that are so complex that they can really stress a rock star out. The same can happen to our rock star scientists. Some methods with complex compounds can be so time-consuming and difficult that they really stress out even the best scientific rock star. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's try and find our scientific zen when tackling a tough analytical problem. John.
Hey, Jen. Boy, Kim looks really stressed out.
She does. I wonder what's bothering her.
Everything!
I think she needs an intervention.
I think so, too.
Do you really have to talk outside my office? I have a lot to do.
Intervention.
Come with us. So, Kim, we brought you here to talk you down. Now, what seems to be the problem?
I have all of these catecholamine and metanephrine samples that I have to run, and I have doctors waiting for these results. Analysis is just so hard to do.
What makes this so difficult?
Well, I have to run two separate analyses. They're very, very polar, and I have to run them by reverse phase. And why are you so difficult? It's so hard to do. I have to run two separate methods, and they all collute on top of each other, and there's so many matrix interferences that I have to try to remove, and the whole thing is just impossible.
A good whiteboard always de-stresses me. Let's look at this in more detail.
All right, I'll try. These are some of the catecholamines and metanephrines that I'm running. And as you can see here from their log P values, they're extremely polar, which makes them very difficult to retain by reverse phase chromatography. If that wasn't enough, they're not stable at high pH, and that really limits my ability to do any kind of sample preparation or to use a different chromatographic method. And if that wasn't enough, the electrochemical detector is always acting up and causing me delays.
That sounds like a tough problem, but there is a solution. Get ready to beat the stress and work will feel like a day at the spa for you.
Can you tell me more about that?
Sure. We have a couple solutions. First, we use Oasis WCX to extract both the catecholamines and the metanephrines at the same time. And then we combine Hallock chromatography with LCMS and do a very, very fast analysis. So in 2 minutes, we can do what it takes an ECD 20 or 30 minutes to do.
But do I have to use Hallock chromatography? I've heard that can be really difficult and hard to make reproducible.
Well, you can do reverse phase chromatography, but Hallock has some definite advantages. And if you're careful, it can work just as easily. As you can see from this graph, when we compare Hallock and reverse phase chromatography, the matrix effects are substantial with reverse phase, but are almost eliminated when we use Hallock. That gives us better sensitivity and also more reproducible data when we're looking at these compounds in different matrices. So here's a few tips and tricks to make this method work well. First, we need to follow the mobile phase preparation instructions very carefully. That's a place where a lot of our clients fall down. Secondly, we need to pay attention to the instrument washes. Hallock is notoriously susceptible to solvent effects, so we need to make sure that those washes are correct. The other thing we have to do is to allow adequate time for column equilibration. Hallock columns take a little more time than reverse phase columns to fully equilibrate. Finally, when we do the SPE, we want to make sure we take enough time to dry the sorbent fully before the final elution step. If you follow all of those, you should have a reproducible and robust method.
One of the cool things in this episode is that cats and Mets are typically two methods. The unique aspect of what you saw today is John combined them into one. Now that is very zen. With the intervention of SPE and help with the tips and tricks, we can now have a successful method and sit back and relax while we get our answers. For more information on this awesome method, go to the link below. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition.